We are live. So, y'all, we're live, and I really wanted to do a, hey guys, really wanted to do an octopus, and I've tried to do an octopus a couple of times, but it never looks the way I exactly want it to. I get really lost in all the tentacles and arms and things. So Jeff is going to help me by doing the line work.
It's just going to be an idea of an octopus. It won't be like eight tentacles, and it's going to be like you'll be able to tell because I want more color in here than detail.
Yeah, same.
I mean, it'll be like I'll just do most of the, like, it's coming in and out maybe of the ink or something.
Sure. I like that. Hey y'all, hey y'all, hey y'all, hey y'all, hey y'all. I hope you've all had an amazing today. What's today? Friday?
Pretty much.
So we are early today because a friend of ours is needing some assistance with their very, very soft opening. It's only staff just to get the feel of protocol. So we said we would grab all of our masks and help out. So, this is going to be a piece that's going along with the series I'm already doing. With all of the colors and alcohol inks and resin. Colorado here and ready for magic. I love it! Finally got a new tablet. I miss so much. We're glad you're back, Rebecca. What is Jeff using? Hey, Shane, we got that torch, by the way. Just came in. Thank you very, very, very much. What is Jeff using?
Just a rag that I've just kind of bunched up on the end.
You're on overhead.
I just put tape down here. Just kind of put another rag inside of it to kind of make it soft. And I'm just pretty much dipping it in charcoal powder. I haven't dipped it yet because I don't want it to be like a dark. Like if I were doing a bunch of shadows like on a big piece, I would use a lot. Like if I was doing strictly charcoal, I would use that. This is just for, it's a little easier to draw something with a bigger utensil, I guess you could say, like when stuff is wide like this. Like you get a better idea of you know, you don't have these little bitty lines that you kind of get lost. I can already see what, you know, where and what I want to do with these tentacles.
How do you and Jeff decide who does the project each day? Asks Karen. So the way it typically happens is it's very organic, actually, because it comes down to who's inspired that day. So for instance, here lately I've been ultra inspired to do these alcohol ink resin images. And so that's what we've been doing lately because that's what I'm inspired by. It's really difficult to create when you're uninspired or distracted. And so the main thing it comes down to is who's inspired by what. And anytime we can do a collaboration with each other, we're always down to do it. And so I feel very lucky that he's so talented and we work well together. If neither one of us are particularly inspired or driven to paint one day, then we'll just do prep work and post a pre-recorded video. But that's usually how it happens. Or we'll pull out from our, we have a bunch of products that get sent to us to review. And a lot of times on the days where we don't know what we want to do, we'll pull from that and do reviews. Unfortunately, we've been super inspired lately, so those are piling up a little bit. There's a lot of people from Chicago in here. Hey, Clara. Painting tentacle with tool. Great tip. Exactly. Creating when you have to is tough sometimes. Clara, you know this because you did the 100-day challenge. If you're not inspired and you just are dedicated to the process of posting every day and you have to like make yourself sit down and do it, it's pretty difficult. Hey guys. Sandy got her air gun in today. I appreciate you saying that, Rebecca. Do you find it difficult to draw from reference?
No, I have to have reference. It's a lot easier to draw from reference.
Karen asks, would you ever use one of those projectors that increase the size of a picture to help you draw out a design?
Of course. I use it all the time. I've used it ever since I started airbrushing. I'm always ready for people that bash those. I don't care. I don't care how you get your artwork done. As long as the outcome is what you intended it and it looks like you want it, and your client likes it, or people like it. Who cares how you get it on there? How you do it? The masters used projectors back in the day.
Yeah, we actually have a projector. Let me see if I can rotate this around real quick. So this is a projector right here. This box that looks like an old school Nintendo. And when we have to do something that has to look like something, in order to save our sanity, not super stress about proportion and likeness, we'll project up parts of it just to make sure that everything is the right way, because otherwise you're just gonna spend, you're just gonna spend all of your time just sketching your image down instead of actually creating, you know? Very well said, Jeff. Oh, yeah, I got my packages today. Also, can't wait for the 25th. I'm so glad, Chain. What's up in Grand Prairie? Are you talking about Grand Prairie in Texas? But we heard that skirt. I was like, what? If you guys don't know, this is Belly Beans. He's one of our studio palms, and he is so exhausted from his day of lounging around and being luxurious. Oh, because Twisted Art Lady is here. You guys, we had AT&T come in again today. Hopefully it's fixed this time. Okay.
I'm just making up parts here. I don't want her to draw every single one of these lines. Hopefully some of this alcohol ink will cover it up. So far, I'm digging it.
Happy Friday. Same to you, Miss Donna Parker. Hey, Miss Sue. What pigment did you use in Florida on that countertop commish that looked like mirror? That was Molito Chrome Marker Refill. You can get it on Amazon. Rebecca says I can't draw a straight line with a ruler. I'm so jealous. So
I'm just gonna start putting people to the test when they say that. And if they can, they're going to get a prize. So we're going to force you guys to draw a line. I'm calling people out for that one. And it's a positive call out because I want people to challenge themselves and have that confidence and be able to say, I could draw a line with a ruler.
So, na 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 boo boo, sticker and doo doo. Very impressed with the B. Thank you. What?
I don't know how alcohol ink's gonna react to that.
Linda said they just spent 15 minutes tracing a dragon with carbon paper, picked it up and nothing. Carbon paper was backwards.
Yep.
Not quite yet, Bethany. I haven't been able to do much today because we had internet tech here. But, and I'm waiting on the mini resin
kit. What do you think about this? Like, what do you think about how light? I can go over this with the pencil if you want and just do a line, and I'm pretty sure that that's super fun there that I just drew that.
So Bethany, I'm still waiting on the mini kits from Stone Coat, but they should be here on the 17th to send out the rest of the little pour kits. I purchased some blue-green glow-in-the-dark pigment from y'all. Do I just mix it like other pigments? Yes, Frenchie.
You said glow in the dark?
Yeah.
Put quite a bit in there. Don't, you know, be generous with how much you put in there. You make sure that it really, you know, that it's really going to glow. I'm just doing all these so that if some of it does come through which I'm hoping that not a lot of this comes through because I don't know what's going to look good or what's not. So
Senior says Jeff has challenged me, and now I can confidently say I can draw now. I used to think that I could never draw. Would suck if you did all the lines and then the alcohol made the lines melt away.
It might, but there's still going to be some with this pencil. So you get an idea of where your lines are, what you want, and if you really like some of the lines that you've drawn, just hit them a little bit more heavier. You're really not going to see them, you know. When you put all this color down, so I wouldn't worry about that.
It's just a guideline.
Yeah, and this is a piece of artwork. Like, who cares if some of them disappear and you have to make stuff up? Like, people are going to know it's an octopus.
Miz, be sweet. That's true. Claire said mix well. Sometimes the glow powders can be tough to mix in and will have little particles. To avoid that, if you put your powder in a cup, no resin yet, and just do a couple drops of alcohol and let that start to dissolve it, and then mix your resin into the powder, it will usually reduce the odds of those little pigment freckles. Hey, Gail. Hey, thank you. Bowie.
That's fun. I like that.
It's wiggly like an octopus. The wiggle is important to recognizability. That is a great word. Recognizability-ism. See if you guys enjoy this video. Please make sure to like, subscribe, and ring a bell so you get notified of every video we post every day. Do what?
I wasn't going to draw that many, but I don't mind it.
Thank you, Clara. Ocean's here. Just got done from swimming in the ocean. Jealous. Did you see an octopus? That's what we're doing today. Gail said, I love watching Jeff draw. Frenchie, I find that powder pigments don't lace or sell, really. In my experience, I'm sure people have been successful. Then again, I don't work with powders that much often because of that very thing. But if you want for sure cells, I would stick with paste or just mix some paste into the piece and so you'll still have cells and also you can use your glow powders.
So that's fun. Some tentacles go where some tentacles go and some don't. So
it's art, I don't care.
That's what's fun about this. So let's say you were drawing this with using charcoal and you got your lines down. You can take this thing, put it in, dab it in the charcoal powder and give yourself, you know, just give yourself a reference of where the shadow would be. Let's say you wanted a shadow on there. You would just draw your shadow on, like, and it fills in a bigger space to where you, it's easier to see it too. Some people have a hard time seeing it, you know, as it goes along. But if you have a big shadow to where something's dark and then something next to it's light, you get where the light source is coming from and where it would be darker in places, like down in where it's coming outside of its tentacles itself and underneath the tentacle. All this is most likely going to go away with all the alcohol ink, but I'm just kind of showing you now that, and you can make that look like it's in the back just by dabbing some dark right here. It's like super fun. I like that. That's fun.
So the base tint's a lot easier to get cells, Lisa. Titanium white from just resin to get cells. First of all, it's a top selling white paste. So it needs to be over the other colors, unlike the stone coat base tint. Needs to be under the other colors for the cells to happen. So for me, my best cells of just resin come from torching it or using a heat gun to push it. You really need to thin it out, but just be careful not to scorch your resin. Secondly, the Color Passion pastes are like the stone coat base tints. So if you really liked how the base tint worked, then just grab yourself some any color from Color Passions that I've used so far, do it. So you don't have to change your process. Jeff is in teacher mode, he sure is. Really getting into the piece, B? Everyone's saying how you're in teacher mode. It's looking really good.
I'm just giving it the outline so that you kind of get an idea of which Like, maybe something, if you think it's too dark, you can cover it, you know?
Oh, no. Put all the lines in that you want. I trust your artistic judgment. I'm just going to add the color and et cetera's. He would have been the cool teacher. I agree. Jeff never wants to be a teacher, however, because he's not a fan. I think his disdain for teaching is that a lot of times art teachers, for some reason, will tell you that what you're doing is wrong, and it's art, so it's subjective. So I think that's why he's like, not a teacher, I'm just a demonstrator. However, I agree, he would have been a cool teacher.
I had cool teachers, so, and they just let me do whatever. Like in high school, I didn't go to college, but in high school they were just like, all right, what you want to do?
Didn't they get airbrushes because you wanted to?
No, they had them. They just didn't know. Mr. Gribble, that's his name. He didn't know how to use them. Really, and then they were just trash because the kids would paint them and just let them sit. Mm-hmm. So they were all trash. So I had to get my own and then learn.
Ocean says, love the ocean. I mean, love the, what's the thing? Octopus that you made me. What a do, Vamp.
Yeah, that was a fun piece.
Right? I love that one. Jude's drum. Hey.
To add some alcohol ink. Stay tuned.
He does give good instructions. Claire says, Jeff would have been the art teacher that you... The art teacher that let you bring the boombox, but only if you played the cool music. That's true. That's fair.
That's very true.
Right, Susan? Everyone agrees with Clara. Joe says, looks good. Jude's drum says, agreed. You both encourage each other. Gail says, it is 8:30 here. Just walk the fur babies and have breakfast. Hello in the future. Vamp agrees, Jeff is a great teacher.
All right, I think I'm done.
I was just about to say that you're loving that so much. I don't know if he's going to let me even art on it.
Oh, of course, I don't. I would spend hours doing this.
I know you would. I'll prep you another board if you want to do that sometime. Is that a board or canvas? That is a cradle board. I'm thinking about carrying the square cradle boards in our shop. Is that something you guys would be interested in? The reason why we started carrying the round cradle boards is because they're kind of harder to find. And by harder to find, I mean, I still don't know where else you can get them.
The circle's making a comeback.
Don't call it a comeback.
Yeah. Look at that girl cat.
I can't see her.
She's on the couch. All right, so do what you got to do.
Crazy. What does ATD consider the cool music? No new school rap and no country, probably, is what he would say. Our favorite is old school hip-hop.
And like old EDM. School hip-hop, EDM, old rock, old heavy metal, new rock.
It's like new heavy metal? Oh, he looks up good.
Techno, a little bit of everything.
Let me show you guys.
I'll listen to some old Garth Brooks, that's about it.
Is it too blown out? Can they see?
It's just blurry now.
Oh.
Put your hand down there so it can like move around a little bit. Yeah. There you go.
Can they see him?
I mean, yeah. Enough.
McGurk, I'm so excited. Oh, did you want to do something with this? I don't want to get any of this AI covered. So, here we go now. Slash nervous. I don't want to wreck it. I'm down to my last this of alcohol.
Yeah, we need some alcohol. We just need to get up at like when the boys get up and just all of us get up and go to all the CVS's, all the grocery stores, like everywhere that restocks overnight. Because everywhere closes now. Like Walmart closes. It's not open 24 hours like normal. CVS closes at a certain time.
I'm scared. But I don't know why I am scared, because this is going to be just easy like a Sunday morning. Easy like a Sunday morning. All right, so my go-to colors right now for all my rainbowy things are Blix Studios Marker Ink Refill in number 077 Magenta. I get those from Blix or digblix.com. The lighter blue that I use is Pool by Ranger. I also like to drip in some Duck Blue from Copic. It is number BG49.
Thank you, Donna Parker. I appreciate that. Thank you, Courtney Ashworth. That's a new name. How are you?
Marabou Rainbow. You can find it on Amazon. You can actually find it on Amazon for like $11, but you can find it on Blick for like $4.99. So, Blick it. Sound weird.
Rebecca Shippey says, I was raised in Panama City, Florida, and I hate country music. There's just some, like, we're just not fans of country. I don't know, she might have been, or maybe she's from Alabama, so I don't know. I'm just saying, you could be.
No.
No? All right.
Maybe one day. Not right now. All right, and the heat gun that I'm going to use is a Wagner embossing gun.
91 proof is awesome. That's the good stuff.
That's the good. Oh! Okay, so now I can't get it back. Okay. So this had these little prong things right here, and I thought it was just to some kind of use that, but I didn't know that they come out and it makes more sense now. Anyways, blonde, what are you gonna do?
What you gonna do when they come for you?
All right, I wanna start with the
Sup
head
car?
And work my way down. Don't hit that button, because that was insane.
You're doing what now?
Start with the head and work my way down.
Ah, I'll let the team have that one.
The team, huh? Okay, so I don't want it to get as dark as the last two that I did. I want it to stay really bright and whimsical. So I'm going to try not to mix the colors too much. But I'm going to start here. I'm going to use blending solution this time. One, because I I'm running low on alcohol, and two, I'm going to be working my way down, and I want it to blend, so reasons
for feeling. Fade that out all over. Just put some color in there.
Right now I'm mainly worried about hitting these edges because I want it to fade inward. So I'm putting alcohol just on these outside parts and blowing inward to create that look.
I have a cousin that has some Airbnbs in Jack's Beach. That was fun. We stayed down there for a couple days. That was a lot of fun. Susan, all she did was paint. She just painted the surface with just a regular roller. With flat white interior house paint, let it dry, sanded it. You could do another layer if you like. It depends on what your surface is. This is already smooth, so you basically only need one layer, unless you can still see through the first layer. So then just sand it, do another layer, and then sand it, and then you're good to go. You sand it with 400 grit and you'll be fine.
But my final is the spray gesso.
Oh, you did spray gesso on it.
Have to top it with spray gesso.
Gotcha. She sanded it with 400 and then spray gessoed it. Let that dry and then sanded it with 400. Yeah.
Well, first coat was 220 because it was a little bit rough, but yeah. Y'all help me think of a name for this guy.
Stay safe, Trina. Hope everything's going well. Have an awesome weekend.
You don't want to use a heat gun. You can also use just a blower to move the color around. Just to get them to marinate a little bit more with each other.
Bethany Park said Oliver, Ollie the octopus.
I like Oliver. I'm digging Oliver. Did I ask out loud what we should name him? In my head, I was thinking to ask you guys.
Sir Inks a Lot.
Okay, that's cute too.
That's super cute. So I got some of this gold leaf in, this simple leaf. I got it in today. That was fast because I ordered it yesterday. It's called simple leaf. Your other speedball, it's just, I believe it's called gold leaf. Like just, let me look, I'll show you. Called Metal Leaf. This is the silver version, but this is the stuff. This Simple Leaf is so fun and so easy, and there's really no cleanup because this stuff is adhered somehow to this paper, and it only comes off if you. I'll give you a little demonstration here. So
Let me brighten this up. This is really dark. I don't know how this got so dark.
The sun setting.
I guess. What you do with this stuff is normally you would put your. I'll do it on. I want to put it on something that's. Here, I just spray painted these. That's not gonna work. So. I just painted these. I don't know if that's gonna work if I. I don't want it to stick to this paint. But normally, when you use gold leaf, it comes very fragile, and if you breathe on it, it just kind of flutters. Like it will just blow away. You have to be very careful with it. This stuff is not like that. What this is I'm going to use this foil pen. This is like, it's an adhesive pen. I'm going to put a different nib on there. Because that one is all used, and I'm going to make some Old English. So, and these pins come with an extra nib so that you can make it like Old English, which is amazing. But you have to make sure all this is coming out evenly. Let's see if we can see if it's coming out. This normally takes a minute. This is a new nib. I shouldn't have done that. So, is anybody working on any new projects today? No, it's not. That stuff, what is the foil that you use for the bee wing?
That is nail foil.
Senior Lisa was looking for it and can't find it.
Claire found it last night. She may be able to add the link. I forgot to add.
All right, so this is coming out very nicely. And this is literally just an adhesive pen. And what I'm going to do is I'm just going to draw some letters on here. This is pretty. I'm going to sand this real quick. You always want it to be nice and smooth when you put leaf down. When you put the adhesive down, you want it to be nice and smooth. So the adhesive is lays flat. Wipe off your surface. All right. So this is what we'll do. I'm just going to put some letters down. I normally do not do an A like this, but for some reason I am today.
on to the other side. Because if I pick up the piece to turn it around so I can reach it more easily, it's going to interrupt everything. I'm also going to pick up this funky brownie orange color that we have somehow made.
Alright, so where I've done that should be a little dry. And then, because you don't want this to dry too long. This pen, it doesn't take long for it to dry. And I probably should have not done that. Some of this might not stick. And so what you do, just rub on the back of this where you've put your glue down. And all right, so I kind of lied. It is a little bit messier, but I did do a lot of detail in here. So to be, what's that word? To be
objective, fair.
Fair. I didn't leave any gaps for the paper. Normally it would just,
it would stick only where the glue is, but since there was nowhere for it to peel off, it's just going to stay there. So I am just going to lightly go over this. Should have, you know what I didn't do is I should have done it every time I did a different letter. You see how that's just blowing away? The AC's on above my head, so. But as you can see, it's not as messy. It probably would have been a little less messy if I would have done one letter, stuck it down, pull it up, take it, do another letter, do it, like, in that way. But there you go, a little easier. Oh, thank you, Lisa. Yeah, I'm not a fan of that. I should just do it. Where, all right, so what I'm going to do, I'm going to make sure there's quite a bit of glue on this one this time. Let's see this. Now I'm just making some letters. Alright, so I'm not going to let that dry too long. I'm just going to do letter for letter. See how it just kind of comes off where it sticks. So now I'm just going to go to the next letter. You don't have to get it all in one swoop. And then, as you can see how I did, it kind of wasted a lot, which is pretty irresponsible of me. So anybody have questions for Erica? Look at that. Wow. Probably be better if I used a paintbrush and put this sizing on. But there you go. And I probably should leave it. I should probably put this on here, let it dry, and then take it off. I'm not wasting any time. Like, I'm just putting it on, leaving, taking it off. I should just put it on there, leave it be for 15 minutes, and then add some more, or take it off then, so that it gives it a chance for the leaf to stick to the glue. But you get an idea. It's a hell of a lot. You save a lot more too. You're not wasting quite a bit. Have you ever used masking fluid with spray paint? I would have to wait until the spray paint was dry before. Yeah, you have to, any masking fluid, and it normally takes a little longer because masking fluid is just, it's weird. I never really use it. You have to really use it on something that's pretty smooth. And I don't know about using it with spray paint because the spray paint might eat it, you know? We haven't gotten any alcohol. Somebody said they wanted to send us some, but it was only 91%, and that's just amazing. That's what we're using right now. 91% and higher is amazing stuff. So yeah, that's simple leaf. It's much better if you use the, she calls it the lady painting glue, but it's the speedball with the Mona Lisa on it, the sizing, and that takes about 10 to 15 minutes to dry. When I say dry, it means that's when you apply the gold leaf. That's the Why am I just, like, dumbfounded for words today?
I have those days all the time.
The accurate time, the ideal time to put down gold leaf.
So, should I go through and try to pick up the ink in between the arms?
Huh?
Should I go in and try to pick up the ink where there's...
No, I was going to look here. Let me show you guys kind of more of a overhead here, what she's got going on.
I'm going to bring that over here.
No, that's fine.
I wasn't sure, like, inside of these
colors. What I want to do now,
leave,
I love it all. I love it all because... A lot of this dark stuff is covering up where something should go up and under. And where some of these lines might not even match with the tentacle. What I want to do is get your alcohol and flood it, and flood this, and flood this, and tilt it up so it runs like.
You want it to run opposite. You want it to run up.
Oh, this is okay. Yeah, sorry, I was turning. I couldn't tell. Yeah, I would run it down.
Okay,
yeah,
so we're not
going to
flood it. We'll just put it on areas like this harder edge, and that will run down, or if you want
to. Yeah, do it to
here,
where it's.
I wouldn't like dump alcohol and then.
Make it run down a lot. Yeah,
so,
no, that's cool.
So, for sure, because I like the look on this as well.
Some of these are a little dark, but you'll
be able
to see
it with the black.
Dries. Yeah.
So let's do.
You're going with what black?
I'm gonna.
Oh yeah, I thought you meant black ink.
No. So if you could go over there, when I lift it up, you can see, because it's already, the table's sloped this way anyway, so like, you can drop it in the areas where we're gonna do that. And let it start to marinate so it can start to fall. Should it, we do that in here as well?
I would just do it one at a time so that you're not hitting other stuff.
Okay.
Right? Or unless you...
I don't know. What is my job over there?
I don't know what... But I'm
to make sure that it's running... Like, see how this one's coming in? I just need you to, like, put alcohol on it to get it to run down if it's...
See?
Flowing the wrong way. This is still just more 91% alcohol. So we put it here.
Yeah.
Put it here and here and here and there. It does it better in these darker areas. It's thicker pigment. So like I would put it where this yellow is already dripping right here.
Just do it.
Well, the reason why I didn't go ahead and go full vertical is so it could just marinate on it a second and pick up ink. Hey, will you get that, when you're done with that, the rag that's under your hand and get that bottom. I think you should grab this dark right here.
Now what you want to do, let's do this so it kind of gets rid of this, is to just tilt it back that way. So then let's see what that does with these. Yeah. That's fine. This one.
Will you do something with this line, because this little dribble right here is not a cute look.
Tilt it.
Yeah, I'm letting it sit for a second so I can pick up more ink.
It's fun when that, when the, what do you call it? Hey, that's so fun. You're blowing it like, to, and then it's gonna go that way. Then it looks awkward. Like when it picks up that blue, it travels with it.
Mm-hmm.
That's super fun. All right, lay it flat.
This reminds me of like fine art version of when people used to melt crayons.
Yeah. I didn't want it to be like that hard edge down there.
Yeah.
This is super fun. It's so fun when something comes together that you kind of see.
Mm-hmm.
It's especially this difficult to control. Can you hit it with the heat gun?
Yeah.
Well, I can't use it at the same time.
Favorite is this area right here.
I'm not a fan of that.
The splash?
Yeah, there's like not, there's no other ones like that. It's like sticking out.
Well, I'm gonna end up adding.
Do you like that?
I'm gonna add this though over so that maybe.
I'm gonna take that out of there. Grab it back. It's just like sitting there. There you go. That's fun.
It does look a little gunshotty.
I'm gonna try to blow something there.
You definitely have to use a lot more patience and heat if you use a blending solution. Pretty sure that's what, again, I had a little bit of pitting and
one of your pieces.
Was it the hummingbird? Yeah, hummingbird had a little bit of pitting.
Did you hear from Dee Dee?
Huh?
Yeah, you said she paid.
Yeah. I'm happy to announce that all of the pieces in this series so far have sold. And also, before I sell any more of them, I'm going to start scanning them so that we can...
Scanning them. Can't scan this.
We can take it to, like, Kinko's, right?
What's open?
Kinko's.
No, they won't. It's all probably just, like, mail stuff. They're not going to be doing...
Well, we're going to have to break out that cannon. All right. Put this stuff aside so I don't spill it as I usually do. Can they see him?
I truly love this series. There's some great texture in the middle. No, there's no pitting right now.
It's just when resin goes over that blending solution, if you don't wait for it to dry completely, you guys are right. And if you don't seal it all the way, it'll have some fading.
If you just joined us, there's an octopus underneath there.
Where am I?
It's just difficult to see. It's just too much. No, you're over there.
Where is it?
No. You can't. You can't see it.
All will be revealed soon. I'm about to go in with a black Posca pen that I thought was right here.
I would use a large one.
Okay.
Are you going to seal it first or you do that last?
I'm going to seal it before I add any gold.
I would seal it before using this because this is just going to... You'll clog that tip up on this.
Okay. So to seal it, I am going to be using UV Archival by Krylon. Very important.
Drop it down.
That you use the matte of this and not the gloss or anything else other than matte. Key is matte.
Yeah, we're doing that, Clara. What's up, JJ? How's the traveling going?
Shake it up really well. And one thick layer is all that you need to have this fully sealed in. And an awesome thing...
It's 6 o'clock. Holy cow.
Awesome thing about it being matte, other than the fact that it won't reactivate your inks, is that when it's dry, it won't be shiny anymore. So that you always know when you can proceed.
I don't know, they might be out of it, but Lisa, she said she can't find archival spray at Michael's or Hobby Lobby. I would just try to look on Amazon. Norma Brock, I am not in troublemaker, just clueless on YouTube and want to be artist. What does that mean?
Hey, Miss Norma. I talked to Miss Norma today on the phone.
Norma Brock? Did somebody call her a troublemaker?
Norma is not a troublemaker, I can vouch.
Well, Lisa, get it before, like, you just get it. If it takes a week or 2 weeks to get here, you'll be one less day down. If you wait a week, it's going to take a lot longer.
A big heat gun to help this to dry more quickly.
Lowe's, I doubt Lowe's would have it, right?
I don't see Lowe's.
That's more of an artist thing. If you live near a Jerry's Artorama, they might have it.
A little bit tacky.
Because Susan, you don't want anything shiny. You don't want anything smooth when you're putting down resin. She asked, why is it matte important?
So on top of the fact that resin tends to pit more over glossy surfaces, the gloss has some kind of alcohol property in it that will reactivate your inks and fade them and move them again, and it'll give a little freckles. Like if you spritz alcohol, is basically what you're doing. But the matte doesn't have that. cool beans. Okay. Marker me, B. Marker me. I'm gonna rotate Ollie the octopus, aka what's his rap name? B, what's Ollie's rap name?
I didn't know there was one.
What's the other suggestion about what his name should be? Something that's a little bit difficult about this, because I'm working with someone else, is that I'm not entirely sure which line goes over what line, because it's sketchy. Is this one in the front over or under? I guess it's over because this is in front.
Hold on. Do you want me to kind of go over it, or?
Yes.
All right, so what would probably be best if you know what I need to do. I don't want to get anything dirty. My hands are filthy. I need...
Do you need gloves? Do you need...
I'm just gonna start with up here.
That is awesome that your art stores are about to open back up. Sir Inks a Lot. Yes. That's his rapper name. Ocean suggested that I look at the picture. So the thing about that is that Jeff used that picture as a rough reference, and it's not exactly as the picture depicts.
Yeah, I mean, I'll look at it for the main parts that I use the reference. But other than that, I'm just gonna kind of guess where I put a line and then add it. That's why I wanted her to go over it so heavily in areas, so we're just getting just the important parts and the fun parts.
Gotta keep the fun parts. Artie the Octopus. That's fun too. Did you get a package today, Erica? We got my new modem in, which I haven't put in yet. Hopefully it will fix my internet issues. Whenever the internet guy comes, it's always 24 hours for some reason before the next internet issue pops up. So that's exciting. I got my new scale for weighing packages. It's a bigger base so that I don't have to worry about Jenga stacking paints, because the one I have right now is about 8 inches by 9 inches or smaller. And Jeff got his leafing brushes and his new simple leaf. So just so you guys know, if you send us anything from like through USPS and it won't fit in a standard apartment size mailbox, which is about the size of my pinky fingernail, it goes to the post office and we have to go pick it up and hope that they can retrieve it in a good amount of time. There's one lady that works at our post office. One! We need one person designated for just the mail that comes through this building. But I digress. If you guys do send us something, VUPS? Nope, USPS. Shoot me a message and let me know so that I can get on to them and look for it. Because if I go up there and say, I got a package here, they'll grab the first one they see and come back out. They don't look and like audit for every package that may be there. So please give me a heads up. I always start with the eye too. Susan says the eye is super fun. I agree. She said you should be getting my package in the next few days. Thank you, Lisa. Ocean said we have an octopus farm here that raises octopus for aquariums so people won't take the ones out of the ocean. People are stealing octopus, octopi? Octopi? Well, that's crappy of people. It's okay, Lisa. Just, we appreciate every time you guys send us a package. And actually, I've had miscommunications with people where I thought we got a package from someone because we did go and get a whole bunch of packages, but the time I opened it, it wasn't the proper package, so there was all this confusion. It's a big mess right now, like a lot of things in the world, and so just give me a heads up. And so thank you for the heads up, Miss Lisa. Dar says, got my ATD package today. Love the colors and absolutely love my shirt. Oh, wait, it's UPS. So if you do send us something UPS or FedEx or DHL, I think there's another carrier. Those usually come to the door here. Okay, there is one thing coming from me, but I don't think. So I have no idea what that means. Hello, Angela. What is up, Miss Ramona? We love surprises. Oh, you don't think it's left there yet? Well, I am super appreciative. Hey, Miss. What are you doing? Can you come up here? Come up here? If you guys don't know, this is our other little hom pup. His name is Cujo, aka Moose. He is 12 years old and thinks that he runs the whole wide world. Yeah, everything takes crazy long in shipping ocean, and it really is crappy for like my shop because it takes so much longer for things to get here, and then people get upset and they like to take it out on me. And I'm probably the perfect person to take something out on because usually I'll take it because I know that people get frustrated and it is what it is, and I'll take it personal. There are days, however, where
just don't.
I'm just not. There's like maybe 5 days out of the year where I push back just a little bit. Thanks, Gina. So, something. So, in this series, I've done. No, the bumblebee is the one that pitted, not the hummingbird. I've done a butterfly, a dragonfly, a hummingbird, a bumblebee, and now we're doing the octopus. What do you guys think we should do next time? Now you can really see the octopus coming together. Thank you, Miss Norma, for all of the thumbs. Well, that's awesome, Holly. If you ordered it from Amazon and you live near an Amazon distribution center, that's the best because you can get same day, next day stuff. Twisted Art Lady says, I push back every single day. I think it's a good thing and a bad thing. So, for sure, it's a good and a bad thing.
But I'm not allowed to answer stuff.
That's true. If someone gets feisty and messages us about something that's absolutely out of my control, like shipping, Jeff isn't allowed to answer it because he pushes back. An elephant, a giant fly with a big old sparkly eye. Harley Davidson, that's not an animal. A sea turtle, jellyfish. We were looking at jellyfish today. A peacock, ooh, I like sea turtle idea. If an elephant, then a horse with a mane from heaven. A parrot, angelfish, seahorse, giraffe. Oh, giraffe. I love giraffe fees. I love all of those ideas, by the way. Something. I am hesitant to do a horse or a unicorn or a dragon because it involves alcohol inks. And Clara is one bad mamma jamma with alcohol inks and animals, particularly horses and dragons. And so I'm going to hold off on doing those particular animals till the next time she comes up here because I'm going to get her to help me. Ooh, a beta would be good too.
Beta would be so awesome.
A buffalo. Sue, I know it's too early for you to have been drinking over there in Australia. Got my eye on you. Harley is known as a hog. Do you want me to draw a pig? A metal horse, I get it. No. Ocean says, I love the thick line of the pen. It looks really good, B. That's crazy, Dar. Are you reserving that for the outer line only?
Yeah.
Mm.
Why?
Because it looks so good.
No, you can't. You can't go all inside of that.
A lion. Okay, I like that. Croc or an alligator. Pegasus. That is another horsey type thing. It can't do without Clara. JJ says, y'all straight murder collabs. Well, thank you. You guys hear Bowie? He's rooting around on the bed. Is there any black on the... Yeah. I was going to ask about that one and the one on the other side. Imagine how the mane could look. It would be brilliant and amazing. I am just not gonna until Clara's up here because she's the bomb.com with it.
That's fun.
Thank you, Dar. A dolphin, that could be fun. I bet you could murder a galaxy with this method. I bet we could actually do like an Aurora Borealis and it would look legitimate. I see a lot of peacocks in there.
Yeah, this is, there's like nothing even connecting.
It doesn't matter.
This is an idea of a...
Are you going to bling this one? I am about to add some sketchy lines and some... I don't know about sketchy lines because it might get busy. Linda says, someone else is about to go live. It's ATD time, people. Go live another time. To be fair, I am early.
You are early.
Eric, I placed an order from you guys, and I hope my ordering separate orders hasn't been annoying. I apologize in advance. Absolutely not, Catherine. Anytime you guys order, I am happy to fill it. absolutely happy. A tree frog. That would be cute. Claire is a dragon queen. She is the queen of dragons. And anything with a mane. Love the bling on these. I do too. I'm debating on adding... Okay, hear me out. Bubbles? And using that stuff that I used for the wings on the inside of the bubble to make it look oil slicky. What do you guys think? A gecko. Miss Judy also said a gecko, and I think that's a good idea too. I'd also like to see a fairy. I have been asked about a fairy as well. Are you taking a photo or? I didn't know if I could come over there.
We've added some alcohol ink and some heavy black lines, a little detail. Next is gold leaf and then resin. I love this. This is an 18 by 36, if you're wondering.
Super fun.
Super fun.
I've got to shower.
Bea, what were your thoughts on bubbles? With the fairy, that stuff I did on the wings?
If you want. Like maybe coming out of his hole. And then some coming out of the little suckers, maybe just kind of randomly.
Yeah.
Don't make them to where they look like they're just floating. Just like,
make them to where, you know, I'm not a fan of that. Like, I don't know, maybe. It's whatever you want. It's whatever you see.
But what were you saying now? I want to know what you're saying. You're talking about like...
It was killing me right there. It was terrible.
Well, where? What?
It's just a part where nothing is there, so it's really bugging me. It's all right. Rainbow dragon and a rainbow horse, definitely.
Gotta wait on Clara for those ones, y'all. And
Clara said that.
Oh.
All right. Catherine, what is your question? I understand that I have to seal wood panels to prevent bubbles from forming in resin. What would be the order I would take to prep the wood for resin? That right there, Catherine, and be very generous with your
enough
polycrylic. And we normally use matte as well of the polycrylic. Just be very generous so that it gets down in there, seeps into those cracks, and fills them up, because that's what causes all those little air bubbles. And just put a good layer, use a foam brush so you can move it all around and just make sure you fill everything. And let that completely dry and sand it, and then start your resin. You're welcome.
noticed if someone actually at the door, or he's still
at it? I don't know. I forgot the door, but leave. Calm down.
All right, you guys. Now it's time for...
It was, I think it was return service. Do you have to pick something up?
Is he here?
He was, and they left it. So that was the first attempt. They'll probably come back tomorrow.
Yeah, that...
Is on there?
That digital scale. They don't really wait that long, do they? Sticky pin. Never mind, I found it. Now we're gonna add gold leaf. I am using, where are you guys? You're over there. I'm using the iCraft Deco Foil adhesive pin. I call it a sticky pin because it's fun. I think I'm gonna mainly do the gold on the suckers. This is like a highlight. I'm gonna use this variegated blue toned foil. And I guess I'm gonna start up here so that I don't get my shirt into I am doing this pretty quickly because I don't care if it skips at all.
What leaf are you using?
The variegated, this one? Do you have a better idea?
I would use like the bright stuff.
The pink
like that's
tone
so
one?
Dark, like you can't even see it sometimes, especially with this.
So you think this one would look better?
Yeah, or this. Alright. I have got to take a shower.
So that is already sticky, which is awesome. I'm gonna try to lay this down without mess upping it. to be pretty specific about where I put all the gold down.
I've probably already forgotten where most of it is.
Have you guys ever used gold leaf? What are your thoughts? Some up here somewhere. Alright, I think that's all of it that I have on there so far. So we're going to keep moving. AC just kicked on, so all of my everything is starting to move. Nope. Appreciate it, Beans, but no. But it's starting to get hot in here, so I'm not going to turn off the AC. I'm going to have to live with it. Sorry I can't see your comments right now, you guys. Jeff went to take a shower because we're supposed to be somewhere between 6 and 10. But we wanted to do this with you guys today, so they can wait. However, I can't see your comments, so if you have a question, hold on to it, or feel free to ask it, and Ahmad will be happy to answer. Something that's good about the sticky pen instead of the Mona Lisa, what's it called? Sizing liquid, is that this stuff sets or dries to the point where you're supposed to use it a lot faster than the Mona Lisa sizing. Sure, there's pros and cons of using either or both or whatever, but it's just my observation as I'm going.
so excited about this piece, you guys. Thanks for arting with me along the process today. No. Very difficult to do this with the AC on. Just pro tip, turn the AC off. Another cool thing about old leaf is if you get it, like if you put the sticky down, whether you use a pen or a sizing liquid, and you miss over or press over something that's supposed to have gold on it, but you forgot where it was or whatever, when you start to dust everything off, it'll still be sticky enough to grab onto whatever you're dusting. So it's not like you really miss it. Alright, now to get up there into the eye area. So if you guys are having a good time, please don't forget to subscribe. And also don't forget to ring the bell so you know when we go live or post a new video. I almost immediately forgot where I put this sizing down. So, also, if you guys think about it, whenever someone asks for videos on how to do resin-y things in any like Facebook group, love it if you guys would drop our channel for referral. Really trying hard to get up to 50,000 subscribers. We can't do it without you guys. Comma, we wouldn't want to do it without you guys. I'm just gonna let those pick up the gold when I dust it off. I'm gonna start down here because it's where I started applying gold leaf. You don't wanna brush it off too soon because you don't want to scrape all the gold off that you just tried to lay down. Gotta let it have time to just stick on there. Let the glue set just a little bit. As I'm picking this up, if I see an area that I think would benefit from having a little highlight or something, I'm gonna add that. So that while I'm dusting it, it can grab onto it. I'm applying a fair amount of pressure, not too much, but I do want to be able to scrape all of this excess off without too much resistance, I guess. Cannot wait to show you guys what this looks like. It's so fun. I think Jeff was right about using the brighter gold. I was leaning towards using the other one because it had blue hues in it, but he was right. Brighter gold looks better.
Just, there's so much detail in that black in there. And I thought about putting quite a few gold in the suckers.
Turn this bad boy around. You guys even see that? I can't see the camera. Now bubbles and resin. Bubbles and resin. Bubbles and resin. Something that's also super cool about doing gold leaf is it sticks to any like thick alcohol ink patches and just adds a little bit of extra gold hints in places where if I tried to specifically put it, it just wouldn't look right. So, okay, I'm gonna use this thing to draw on some bubbles. Bring back a pencil.
Like I'm crazy. It's like, what are you looking at?
Oh, man. So, not big, right, B?
What's not big? Oh, wow. Yeah. Man, that looks great.
So,
awesome.
Unless you want to do this and I can just brush my hair. Which is, I don't mind. I'm just saying if you want me to start.
Yeah.
I probably won't resin it tonight. I just want to finish the... The stuff I'm going to use for the bubbles is this. It's called, I don't know what, but what it is nail foil. So when your nails are almost dry, they'll put this on there to give it some like sketchy sheen. And I was like, I'm going to use that with resin. Turns out it works. And so now I'm going to add it to bubbles because it will look like, you know, when you blow bubbles, it's got that oil slicky iridescent-y look. That's the idea with this. I think I'm gonna add just a little bit into his eye. I'm gonna wait till it's tacky. And it's important when you use this, you kind of would think that you want to put it the pattern side face down. That's not the case. You want the pretty part to be face up. If you just push a little pressure on there, that stuff will come right off. Oh yeah, that's fun. I don't know if you guys be able to see it, but I'm going to give it a shot. You look right inside his eye and the pupil, that center part where I put this stuff. So Jeff's going to take over and draw some bubbles while I go look not homeless real quick.
So how much do you want to do and how do you want to stop?
Just make it cute.
Make it cute. Alright, so... Looks great. It's funny, she only did this. I was gonna do an entire sucker, but that looks awesome like that. Very nice. Alright, so I guess we'll just do them like where they're coming off of certain areas. I'm not sure.
What if we did like oval?
is this working? Has she got this working good? Looks okay. So let's do that. This right here. She covers it all the way, right? All of it? I want to make sure I dot that down so that probably be best to do it like this. Just kind of take your time and put your sticky stuff down. So that I'm not sure that's like coming out very well, so we're just gonna do those dots and then we're gonna do the stuff here. So you put this side down, and then you put this side down. Oh man, that's super fun, y'all. I'm gonna do it nice and slow. I would definitely do a dot and then do the bubbles, and do a dot and do the bubble. Because this stuff dries pretty quick, especially with the temperature in here. It feels a little hot. We have this window open over here too, so. Just not wanting to come out. Maybe I should wait. Is it just not wanting to come out? Like, what is up with that? There we go. Here, it's gonna wait a little longer. Yeah, that's super fun. Get some. It's hard to tell if this glue is coming out, so. Maybe if I put that little heat gun on it. I don't know why that's stuck like that. That's weird. We're gonna have to make a bigger bubble. That's the trick. Just let it dry for a little bit. Sorry I can't read you guys from over here. I can't see your comments, so. Can you guys even see what I'm doing? I can't see the screen, so. That's Ron. He's probably going to be yelling at me anytime now. I've got to get... Yeah, that's fun. Bubbles! Hold on, y'all. Yes. And you guys, I can't read your comments when I'm over there. I can't even see what I'm doing right now, so I'm gonna change that so you can kind of see where I'm at over there. Alright, so let's do a couple small ones over here. You can see it. You just got to be really careful with it. Very patient. It's coming out. That's fun. All right, let's do these little guys over here. I'm really surprised that this is coming out as much as it is. Like, normally these pins kind of dry up pretty fast if you're not using them right away. I don't know where she put the lid to this one. I did. Alright, so we got three down here. And you know that it's sticking when you push down on it and you can see the little imprint of the circle. That's super fun. I asked Ron, when do you want me to be there? He's like, now! This is a big deal. This is basically a test to see how people are doing when you open up something. And you know, if you leave your thumb on there, it gives it some heat, and then it sticks, like it almost dries it faster. Oh yeah, those are nice bubbles there. That's fun. That is driving me crazy there. I'm not good at placing things like this. Let's see here. I would put this closer, but I can't tell where I'm at on the screen. It's like you think it's gonna stick, then it does not. It's funny, there's like they're like little, they stick where the you did the circle at. Not in the middle. But it looks good. Yeah. I like it. Here, here, there's some coming up here. I think you just have to wait. And I apologize if I can't see y'all's comments or questions. Am I off the air? Ooh, yeah, it's best if you just let this set, like. It does get sticky. I forgot I put that one up there. That is good and sticky. Oh yeah. Now I just gotta remember where I put them. Definitely best just to let him set for a couple minutes.
I'm trying to look at the angle. Like you can kind of see, you could probably just run your hand over it. And there we are. That's enough. Looks good. I think we got enough bubbles on there. I think I'll put a couple, just a little bit right up here by his top. That'll be good. Yeah, it's that little... Let's try this little guy. There's still like a little wet dot, and it's still a little bit too moist. I know how you guys love that word.
go. Running out of spots. There we go. Resin. I don't think we're going to be doing resin tonight, though, so I apologize if you thought maybe we're going to do some resin. I've got to go support my friend Ron. Alright, so there you go. Let's see if y'all can see the bubbles. This is going to look so good with resin on it. Yeah, buddy. All right. Are we still live? It looks like it. let's see here. So, where did he go, y'all? You're just now asking that? She went to go put a face on and brush her hair a little bit. We have got to be getting. Thank you guys so much for sticking around for 2 hours and 20 minutes. You guys are awesome. Tomorrow, I'm sure that we will do the flood coat of resin. I don't think she's gonna put any rocks on it, any fire rocks or glitter glass on this one. I don't think it would look right. So with that said, we appreciate each and every one of y'all. We wouldn't be anything without you guys. You guys are awesome. Is this in the like I'm crooked. Thank you for your support and coming and hanging out and chatting and giving us suggestions and all you blue wrenchers out there. Thank you for helping us do that as well. Answer questions and keep the feed in line. Love this piece. Thank you. It looks wonderful. Thank you.
Thanks, you guys.
So with that said, be kind to one another. You never know what somebody's going through. We'll see you tomorrow, probably the same time, probably a little early, depending on what we got going on. As you can see, the Pour With Us class is still on for May 25th. Just go to our website, artisttelldeath.com, buy the Pour With Us kit. Tune in 8 p.m. on the 25th, and we will show you from beginning to end how to pour and do a swipe. It's fun for the whole family. I would say 12 to 13 years and up. Definitely supervise the teens. And it's a lot of fun. And if you already have the supplies, if you're already doing it, join along. Of course, you can join along. And this is for beginners and advanced and all ages from 13 and up. So you guys have an awesome Friday night. Thanks for staying alive. Thanks for staying safe. Washing your hands, all that stuff. Obviously, you guys have already been doing that your whole life. So have a good night, and we will see you tomorrow. Bye. Bye.